Folks, thanks for tuning in. This is episode one, following myself and Charlie Jung, aka Charlton Banks on Instagram, on our fat loss training and diet journey. We're gonna have a few videos for you over the next coming weeks, just talking about various parts of doing a fat loss phase and training and sort of how we feel about things. If you're looking for more objective content, you can log on to all of our Renaissance Periodization stuff and the rest of the YouTube channel stuff for how to train. Here, we'll talk a little bit about that, but a lot more about the psychology and the approach to training and to doing a fat loss phase. And of course, the first video, as titled, is all about the plan. And the plan really just means that before you endeavor to do something meaningful that's going to accomplish things, that's going to lead to impressive changes, you almost certainly have to have a plan. Charlie, when you see people sort of embarking on difficult things and you notice that they don't have a plan, what's your first thought?
Well,
yeah.
Boy. You in trouble.
Lord, child. But seriously, like, people will endeavor to say, like, you know, I'm gonna lose like 30 pounds over the next, like, sure, you know, 4 months. And it's okay. And they're like, yep. And they're like, so what's the plan?
Yeah. It's really wild when I see people, like you said, go on these journeys to hit a certain goal, and they're quite lofty sometimes, especially when people train or like for weight loss or weight gain, and they don't have little tiny steps along the way that they're gonna hit, sure, to get to that end goal.
And also, like, if you have an end goal that's lofty, but you haven't planned for it, you might not even know it's lofty because you haven't planned for it. Like, once you plan to send a rocket to the moon, or once you decide to go to the moon, you're like, okay, I wanna go to the moon. Okay, sweet. So what's the plan? Like, well, we gotta build a rocket. Oh, holy crap, building a rocket is hard.
And that building a rocket has like multiple components that each in its own have a plan.
100%. So like, when people say, I wanna lose, you know, 20 pounds or 30 pounds or whatever, let's say 20 pounds over, you know, 16 weeks. And you say, well, how many, you know, roughly how many calories a day are you gonna eat during that time? And they're like, I haven't really figured it out. You'd be like, well, you just run the numbers, just real quick math. And then they look at the number they get and they're like, well, that's not a whole lot of food. And you're like, yeah. And they're like, maybe I should just lose 15 pounds. It'll be more food, it'll be more sustainable and easy. And then all of a sudden the plan works to actually refine your goals, because once you see the kind of plan you have to have in order to get your goals that might not be realistic, you see that the plan is not realistic to execute. And that's sort of part number two about a plan, is the plan is what tells you what is going on every day. So when Charlie and I go to train, we have every single one of our workouts mapped out for every single week. They're generally mapped out for every single week of an entire mesocycle, which is usually 4 weeks of accumulation training and 1 week of deload. And then within each week, after we finish a certain week, we already have all the numbers to completely fill in the blanks on everything we're gonna be doing in the next week. There's some autoregulation play with reps in reserve, and it might, you know, we're shooting for 15 reps, it might be 13, it might be 17, but it's a very, very tight-knit plan. We do not go in and do random workouts. We don't choose our exercises the day of. It's all laid out. We know exactly how many macros and calories you're gonna be eating every single day. We're down to the point, and we'll have another video later for you guys about how we deal with stuff when we travel, because we travel for work a lot. But we even have a plan of how we diet on travel weeks. When we're at home, we actually dip more hypocaloric, because when you're on the road, despite your best efforts, some of the food has a little bit more fat in it, especially from restaurants, than they say. So we even counter for that. And, you know, so having a plan is super important. So we planned our workouts, we planned our diet. We have ways of updating and auto-regulating the plan just in case. But if you're endeavoring to do something special, like lose a bunch of body fat or get really strong, you go nowhere without a plan, or you get somewhere and you actually won't be able to replicate the results.
Yep.
There's another one is like, you did something. How many times, Charlie, in powerlifting, have you like talked to someone who like hit a PR at the meet? You're like, what was your training cycle like?
Yeah, and they just go like, I don't know, I just lifted a lot of weights and I maxed out 2 weeks out and that's it. That was their plan, pretty much.
And then so like, you're like, so how are you gonna make sure you get PRs next time? What are they gonna say?
Not
who
much.
Knows, right? Who they knows? Just, I'm just gonna do stuff and hopefully it adds up. So it's all about having a plan. And the thing is like, the plan can be rigorous. The plan can be monotonous. Sometimes you look at the workouts you're supposed to do on paper and you think, fuck, I wanna do that shit.
Yeah, sure. And but I think also like that helps you in a way, because I see a lot of times, like you said, people go in for their workouts and they don't have a plan at all. They just kind of pick out what they're gonna do, you know, that day on the spot by feel. You know, sometimes that's fine, but sometimes you can kind of overdo it sometimes, even at a point where you kind of shoot yourself in the foot. 100%. And kind of ruin your next week of progression and following week of progression.
Even the next session of progression, because like, so when Charlie and I train, we have multiple muscle groups to train every single week, and we train the same muscle group multiple times a week. So if you have three chest workouts a week or chest tricep workouts, if you overdo it on one, the next one sort of sucks and you're left sort of picking up the pieces. It's a matter of making sure you do the right stuff every time so that you can have checkmark great workout, great workout, great workout, instead of amazing workout that might even be too damaging for you to recover from properly and still grow. And then the next workout has to suck, or the workout after will really suck, or you get hurt or something like that. So having a plan is about making sure that you're working at the appropriate level of volume, intensity, so on and so forth, and working appropriately with diet. Then it means that sometimes you're gonna have days where you're just raring to go, you just can't wait, but you gotta hold back. Yep. And then sometimes, especially towards the end of mesocycles, towards the end of the diet, you'll have a lot of days where you look at the sheet, what you're supposed to do, and you're like,
and you don't think you can do it.
I'm not gonna do this.
But the great thing about a plan is you know you have to do it.
You have to do it. Yeah. Yep. And then you do it, you succeed, and better. And then the same thing goes with diet. You know, a lot of people, when they start a fat loss phase, will instantly drop their calories by a ton because they want rapid gains or rapid losses. They want to see instant results. And what they're not thinking about is when you drop your calories super low early, when your body fat loss starts to stall or your metabolism starts to decline a little bit, your NEAT, your sort of involuntary activity starts to go down because you've been dieting so hard for a while. When that starts to happen and you got 1 or 2 months left of fat to lose, what adjustments are you gonna make?
Where are you gonna go?
Nowhere.
Yeah.
So it's all about planning. Is not just about laying out a foundation. It's about long-term thinking as well. We think, you know, I'm gonna lose roughly a pound a week, every week, pound, pound and a half. And yet, would it be sweet if I lost 3 or 4 pounds in the next couple of weeks and just was way ahead of schedule? In a sense, yes. But then you have to do something about that. And it turns us into this yo-yo thing. So if you're dieting, if you're training, have a plan, make sure it's adaptable, but make sure it's steering you in a proper course. A big part of the plan in weight training also means using similar or the same exercises and rep ranges week to week to week. Every mesocycle we can reevaluate, but generally speaking, we want to use more or less the same movements week to week to week, add a little bit of weight to the bar, add or subtract sets as needed for recovery, exercises in which weight additions are not super realistic, like lateral raises for dumbbells, then we can add reps. But it's all about making sure to just eke a little more and a little more and a little more. And the goal is, on the long view, that last workout of the last accumulation phase when you're almost done cutting, that last week should be as far as you're able to push. 100% as far as you're able to push. But everything short of that should be some percentage of that. And people talk about going all out and balls to the wall.
Well, going balls to the wall is easy.
It's not that hard. Training hard is not that hard. Like, I mean, unless you're 13 years old and you've never been pushed before, like if you've done competitive sports and you're a fucking grown man or a grown woman, like you can go to failure. It's not very challenging. You can scream a lot. We'll do plenty of that. Yeah. But don't pat yourself on the back too hard. If you follow a plan that is adequately challenging and you do it consistently.
That's the hard part.
That's the hard part. Show me a motherfucker that goes to the gym and goes super crazy past failure and then disappears from the gym for 1 or 2 weeks. And I'll show you somebody I'm highly uninterested in. Show me someone who can stop at 2 reps in reserve or 1 rep in reserve or go all the way to failure predictably when the plan calls for it, and who comes in workout after workout, week after week. And that is a person who is on their way to maximizing their genetic potential.
Yep.
Yeah. Either you fail to plan. No, if you fail to plan, you plan to fail. But you're really not planning then.
Yeah.
So you're gonna fail by accident, like everything else that happens to you in your life if you don't plan. Folks, plan, and see you next time for the next video.